Hello everyone! In this video, I will introduce you how to work with the Capture Profile Editor in ActivePresenter. Whenever you start creating a new capture, ActivePresenter will offer the Capture Profile Editor for more specific settings. In the Capture New Project window, click Edit Capture Profile icon to open it. This window contains 5 different tabs dealing with different specific areas, and in this video, we are going to details of all 5. Firstly, we get to know the General tab. This tab allows you to have very basic and generic settings for your capture in terms of capture profile, capture type, and panning. The Capture Profile section shows you the name of the profile and its description. Under the capture type, you can choose the Smart Capture or Full Motion Recording mode. When you select Smart Capture, ActivePresenter will record your screen and take a screenshot whenever you do a mouse click or a text type. Moreover, you select automatically use full motion recording for either drag and drop actions or mouse wheel action. ActivePresenter will switch automatically between the Smart Capture type and FMR Capture type. That means that you can capture in the Smart Capture mode, and ActivePresenter will switch to the FMR whenever you drag any item or when you scroll or wheel the mouse. On the other hand, the FMR mode allows you to record your screen like a camera with a fixed frame rate per second. It does not respond to any mouse or keyboard input, therefore you have no further choice like the Smart Capture. Automatic panning is used when your capture frame is smaller than the recorded application screen and you want to freely move the frame to any part of the screen. Whenever you move the mouse on the screen, the capture frame will follow it. It's very useful if your target application has many controls. Then define the panning speed that the frame will follow your mouse movement. Now I will introduce you the Audio and Video tab. This tab contains two sessions, providing you more choices for video and audio. Access the video codec drop-down list and choose the one you like. Flat screen video is the loosely codec which creates videos with quality reserve. Other 3 are lossy codec types which create videos with smaller file size and lower quality. When it comes to frame rate, you should keep it in the range of 20 to 30 frames per second. Too high value may increase your video size and over some lagging computer, while too low values make your video appear jerky. This is number of continuous non-keyframes between keyframes. It's recommended that you should let it be in the range of 4 to 400. When it comes to quality, the higher quality you select, the larger video file size and vice versa. The quality option is activated only when you select one of the 3 lossy video codecs. Similar to video settings, ActivePresenter offers you a lossless codec like 16-bit PCM and lossy codecs which are Vorbis and MP3. You can choose the sample rate for your audio here. It determines the fidelity of the audio. The higher sample rate increases the fidelity and audio size and vice versa. Select mono or stereo from channels. In comparison with mono, stereo channel needs double storage size. Now we come to the cursor tab. This tab allows you to have settings for cursors in a recording video. It's recommended that you should select the checkbox when recording video demonstrations because ActivePresenter will record the mouse movement and it's easier for your audiences to follow your steps. Otherwise, your video will have no mouse cursor. If the checkbox is selected, you will be able to edit the cursor properties such as highlight, mouse click styles, and effects in your recorded video. Click More Settings, and here's where you can change the cursor properties. Choose the mode that you want the cursor to be shown in Show and Mode section. Change the cursor highlight in terms of type, color, opacity, and size. In the Movement Path section, if you select Straight, the actual mouse path between 2 clicks will be replaced by a straight line. On the other hand, if you select Curve, ActivePresenter will maintain the actual mouse movement. Finally, define click sounds and effects. You can import audio file from your computer from here. After all the changes, you can still come back to the original values by clicking the Restore Defaults button. Now is the time for the Annotation tab. The annotation is only activated when you choose Smart Capture mode. This tab gives you controls over annotations and interactions that are automatically added during the capture. It has two main sections containing settings for mouse and keyboard. Select the checkboxes if you want to add annotations to guide viewers how to operate. Those hints can be shaped with text inside telling learners how to behave. And select correct, incorrect, or hint box if you want to provide feedback messages corresponding to user actions. Now we come to final tab of the Capture Profile Editor. The Hotkeys tab allows you to set the keyboard shortcuts for various functions. Remember to select Use Hotkeys to activate all of the properties below, and just change them into keys that you like. Now click Save to save all the settings that you have made with the Capture Profile Editor and start recording your screen. So we have covered details of 5 tabs in Capture Profile Editor. Hope that it helps in setting and customizing your projects. Thank you for watching.